In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to set up Adobe Illustrator when designing a logo for your graphic design projects. So follow along and learn how to set up Illustrator perfect for logo designing. Welcome to today's quick tutorial on how to set up Illustrator for logo designing. Tomorrow I have a really cool tutorial on how to make vector brush stroke typography, so stay tuned for that guys. The first thing we need to do today, obviously, is to make a new document in Illustrator. Give it a relevant name, and then the size I like to keep above 1000 pixels, but seeing as the design is a vector, this isn't going to be so important. Vector graphics hold their quality scaled up or down to any size, unlike raster graphics. I use CMYK as a color mode for print, and always 300 ppi high quality resolution. You can adjust the amount of artboards you want to use here, and then click OK. So here are my three artboards in Illustrator for logo designing. However, we can take the artboard tool here, and we can actually move the artboards around on the screen, adding them where we want to feel most comfortable when designing a logo. Also, if you hold down the Alt Option key, you can duplicate the artboard and also change the artboard name whilst using the artboard tool. We're going to further set up the document for logo designing Illustrator, so first press Command or Control R to open up your rulers. You can then control or right click the rulers themselves to change the measurements, and I personally like to use millimeters or pixels most of the time. The first preference that I make sure is activated for logo designing Illustrator is the Smart Guide preference. Now you've all seen me mention the Smart Guides a lot on this channel, but they're really essential for logo designing especially, so I need to include them when setting up a document for logo designing Illustrator. So when I now select the pen tool and draw out a shape or design, Illustrator will give me all kinds of guides and notifications when my vector path is aligned, centered and spaced apart from other objects. This is super useful when being precise with your logo design projects. The next preference I change is the increment of a single nudge in Adobe Illustrator. So when I use the arrow keys to move an object left, right, up or down, this dictates how far it moves across the screen. So this needs to be set up relevant to the size of your document and the kind of design that you're working with. It's annoying when you're pushing an object and it moves too little or too far along the screen. The next part of my document setup for logo designing Illustrator is to make sure I have quick access to the Pathfinder window. Pathfinder tool is an essential part of most logo designs for me, and I like to have quick access to it and its functions. You can find it in the window drop-down menu, or you can find it at the toolbar at the side. I like to actually drag it out from the toolbar itself and move it somewhere I can access it easily. Another tool that I make sure is readily available is the Shape Builder tool, which works in a similar fashion to the Pathfinder tool by using shapes to make other shapes, but kind of different, if that makes sense anyway. Another preference that you might want to take notice of for your logo design project is a user interface. I always have mine set to a dark display because I don't like the constant bright glare of a white background on my eyes. You may very well be spending multiple hours staring at the screen, so do your eyes a favor and darken the screen. Depending on the logo design, you might want to open up the grid, which you can do here in the View drop-down menu. This again will help you to be precise in the geometric logo designs and other logo design projects. So for example, drawing a square freehand in combination with the smart guides is easily done. Lastly, when logo designing, if you already know the colors being used beforehand for your logo, it's best to make sure that you have Pantone selections of those colors. You can use CMYK, but I feel using a Pantone color and telling the client what that Pantone actually is, feel to make absolutely 100% sure the client's logo is going to be printed the same on any machine around the world. Sometimes the client even requests to me that their logo design is actually Pantone. So with my color choices here, I can select them and then go up to Edit, Edit Colors, and Recolor Artwork. Then choose the color libraries and find the Pantone uncoated colors. You would then have changed the color to a Pantone color, which will be evident in the swatches window as well as in the color window, where the Pantone ID will be displayed. So there is today's video on how to set up Adobe Illustrator, perfect for logo designing. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video down in the comment section below, and of course drop a like on the video if you did enjoy it. Now if you really find my content useful, share it on social media so other people can see my tutorials and my graphic design content right here at Satori Graphics. Subscribe to my channel for 4 weekly graphic design uploads, and if you have done already, hit the bell notification so you're reminded when I upload a video on this channel here at YouTube. Now speaking of YouTube, they're making it difficult for some subscribers to actually see my content. They only send out my content to certain people who they deem worthy. So if you do turn on the notifications, you're going to be notified via email when I upload. And just so you know, I normally upload Monday, Tuesday, Thursday and Friday every single week here at Satori Graphics. But anyway guys, until next time, design your future today. Peace.